What's up, guys? This is Evan with Off Block Chronicles, and we're here with Nathan. Two out of the three. Austin's not with us right now. Where is he, Nathan? Is he in, like, Yosemite or something, I think?
Yeah, I think he's in Yosemite.
But, anyway, we're doing this video kind of to introduce ourselves, give you guys kind of a voice with the channel, to know who we are, so it's not just, you know, faceless content. As it has been, just a bunch of compilations. Give you guys something to laugh at, hopefully. And, so we're just gonna kind of introduce Nathan in this video, ask him some questions, and hopefully entertain you guys. So,
did you prepare questions?
Yeah, kinda. Not really. I just looked up questions on the internet. Cause, you know, that's how I roll. But, see, first question, Nathan. What was your favorite food when you were a child? Or if you still are a child. I mean, I guess you can consider yourself one, but...
Oh, man. Tick buck. I'll be fatter. Favorite food as a child. What is, like, give me a... What is it? For breakfast? For dinner? For lunch? Which...
If it was your last specify. Meal, what would you eat?
That's impossible.
Impossible? It's not impossible.
There's just so many foods I enjoy. Food's a great thing.
Okay, favorite. Let's go by category. Let's go like carbs, proteins.
What?
Desserts. What's your favorite meat?
Too specific. Eliminate my favorite all meat.
Yeah.
My favorite meat.
No, I did not.
Well, I'm trying to think, because generally I would just, in general, just say steak, but. There was something I ate recently.
What was it?
I don't remember what it was.
How do you not remember if you liked it?
No, I remember I liked it. I just don't remember what the hell it was. Let's just go with the general. Oh! Headshot. Let's go with the general. What's it called? Steak. We'll just go with steak.
Alright, how do you like that steak? You like it well done?
I like it medium rare. Well, because. Anytime I tell them to do well done, they do it. Obviously, they do it to the point where it's dry because you're asking for it well done. Yeah. But I like the medium well because then it's still because they usually undercook it. Sometimes depends on where I go, but medium well because it's still juicy, but it's still thoroughly cooked for my taste. Because you know, I like
all grits. No, yeah, I feel it. Okay. I mean, whenever I ask for everything. Medium well, I still get well done. It's just like, So I never know. I mean, some really good steak restaurants still do it right, but others are just kind
of... Oh, me!
Bleh.
I've got you.
Dead.
Thanks, mate.
That's overkill.
Danger Wolf.
That's overkill.
Down. Rick. Oh. Got you, Holmes.
I got you!
Alright. So, next question. Well, I guess we didn't really finish that question. What's your favorite starch/carbohydrate? You like rice, you like potatoes, you like...
Oh, potatoes.
Potatoes.
The fuel of the Martian.
Yeah.
The Martian-grown potatoes.
Do you like that movie, Nathan? Just a little bit, maybe?
It is one of my favorite movies. I watch it every week.
For those of you that don't know, yeah, exactly. Nathan watches that movie, Interstellar, and what was the other one? Every single week.
Interstellar, The Martian, and Arrival. I try to watch them at least once a week.
Must be nice having that much time, man. Well.
It's only like the most it takes. If I watch them all in sequence, then that's like almost 6 hours, but I don't watch them all at once. You have to spread them out. The Martian, I just watch whenever.
Frick!
Because I have
great
breaks between classes, dude.
Yeah.
I got a 5-hour break between one of them, so I can watch Martian and Interstellar in that break.
Go back to your place like I can. We're both college students, by the way. We go to different colleges, unfortunately. Tier. I live about 3 hours away now. Tier. But, yeah.
Evan's the business. What would we call Austin? Evan's if you'd be the business, I'd be the... He would technically also be the science, I guess, but we could say he's the sports since he's still trying to do sports.
Well, you know, I mean... I could
be
the sports
guy.
He could
be more
guy.
Than one thing,
I'm
but
coaching,
it's all
dude.
Be one-dimensional.
I mean, come on.
You are a coach.
Yeah. Be that varsity O-line well, coach. Holla at your boy. But...
For what?
Man. But, okay, next question. Let's see. You know, this is going to be hard for you, too.
I don't think we finished the food pyramid.
Did we? I don't know the food pyramid.
I don't know.
Are you a nutrition major, Nathan? I didn't think so.
I'm an aerospace engineer major.
Exactly.
Like me.
Exactly.
I'll build a rocket and I'll go to the top of the pyramid.
I don't think the pyramid's that high, but with the amount of carbs you eat, you know, with all that freaking candy. And what else? Did you finish that gummy bear game controller you had? Or I guess not.
Dude,
a bear,
I just ate
gummy
the thumbsticks.
Game controller.
I just ate the thumbsticks.
Wait, so like the That's thumbsticks always... were like out and pronounced and everything?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh. I should have taken a picture, but dude, it's infuriating to try to eat this thing. Oh my god, it's so tough. I need a steak knife.
Jeez.
I mean, I don't want to eat it now because it's 12 o'clock where I am. But I mean, we're in different time zones, Evan.
Obviously, I'm exactly 18 minutes ahead of 12 o'clock here. So open window, going for it. Can't repel. Okay. Where are you? Alright, so second question. It's gonna be hard for you and for me. What's the number one most played song on your iPod?
That changes from time to time, so right now I'd probably have to say. Oh, fudge. Oh, I could probably check actually now that I don't really. It's not a question I have to think about. Let's see.
Yeah, just ask your handy dandy Google and be like, hey. Oh, ah. I wasn't watching.
Danger Wolf, K9. Funny name.
Got him, and go down.
Yeah, cut my nails, they're annoying me. Alright, I gotta go with my options. I don't know where it is whenever I go to.
Just ask Google and be like, what's my most played song? I'm telling you, dude.
Alright. I don't know if it'll be able to do that. I guess we could try it, let's see. Okay, Google. What is my most played song? Nah, Google just told me they don't recall.
Frick.
Oh!
That was trash. I'm trash, I'm sorry.
I got blown up. let's just go through my playlist. It's between... It's gonna have to be between... What You Want... Beastie Boys.
Still that Beastie Boys hype after how many years?
Since
just
1986.
I guess.
I wasn't born yet, but you know. Freaks and Geeks. Childish Gambino, that's another one. Hold You Down, that's another good one I've been listening to a lot. Kids. The New Style.
I'm actually kind of curious now, too. I'm gonna go look. I think my most played song. Let's see, wait.
Zolcon. That's another good artist. Rest of Ghosts.
Yeah, top 25 most played.
Dude, I don't know if I have those. Oh, wait. Maybe I do.
I haven't listened to any of these songs in at least a few months on my top 25 most played. That's a lie. What I've been listening to myself is I've been getting into like Spanish music. Like ever since I went to Spain, dude. Some of the music.
What? Oh my god.
No, I'm serious. Like, alright, there's this guy that I found. I don't know how to say his name. It's like Maluma or something like that. But.
Maluma.
Yeah.
Maluma.
He's kind of lit.
I also listen to speeches.
The song that I've been listening to is Sing. I don't know how to say this. Sin contrato? I don't know. Something like that. And then Shakira, of course. Always. This one at Ricky Martin. Vente pa' acá. Alright. Love me some Tinashe, too. Mm-hmm.
What?
Yep. Alright. Question number three. What's one of your favorite quotes? I think I know the answer to this one. You were saying the speech yesterday, but anyway, what's one of your favorite
speech?
Quotes?
The speech favorite of quotes? Speeches.
Yeah.
You know what's funny is there was because I follow a group that's basically just dedicated to Carl Sagan, and one of the recent posts was, "It's Sagan Sunday. Post your favorite Carl Sagan quote." And I had to post a bunch because it's hard to choose. One of them that I have on like my Instagram is, "Somewhere, something incredible is waiting to be known." And then a bunch of other ones. Don't I have Facebook? Don't you? They carry your like. You have like a quotes things you have.
I don't know.
I don't think I filled it out.
I don't
actually.
Really use Facebook. Facebook bugs the grits out of me.
I know.
I told
you
before. There's just so much extra stuff to sift through to see what you want. Like every time I go on there, which is like once every 2 months, if that, it's like. Yeah, like, look at this article, look at this documentary, look at this ad, look at this new product. Like, no thank you, I'm okay.
You could block things, you know.
Yeah, but then that requires at least 2 taps, and that's more taps than I'm willing to give, so.
Eliminate all. You're not gonna tap that?
Heck no, 10 out of 10 would not tap. Alright.
Oh wait, here's one. Oh shit, I'm Rook. I was paying attention because I was looking at quotes.
Dang, it's just getting wrecked.
Another Carl Sagan I really like is, "If we crave some cosmic purpose, let us find ourselves a worthy goal."
Wrecked.
Oh yeah.
Okay. I like it.
Oh, I'm dead. Oh, I'm okay. Alright. Oh shit, I'm dead.
What was your quote for the 8th grade yearbook? I remember that one. That one was pretty funny. I think it was like,
"No, I don't suffer from insanity. I enjoy every minute of it."
Yep.
Oh, that was the year my dad was like, "You can do whatever you want in 8th grade." I was like, "Cool." So I took a really weird picture, and then I put that quote with it.
I always wanted to do this that, but I knew my mom would not be happy with that.
Where? Where is this? I'm gonna die right now trying to help this guy, but...
I got you. Loading mag!
Oh... Alright, I'm Rookie. I'm gonna run away. Ah! He's in that room.
Reloading! Flash bang. Alright, question number 4.
Bang bang!
Well, I guess you'd be 4 and 4.5. What's your favorite outdoor activity?
Okay, so the one that I've most recently been doing is obviously snowboarding, but generally,
where you come from? What the heck?
Generally what I've been doing, I would say, is stargazing. It's gotta be one of my tops. I do it all the time. Or I try to, at least.
Do you use binoculars? Or
really relieves stress. I have a telescope.
Freak. Oh, okay.
Good little entry telescope. Celestron. I forgot the model number. I just remember it's a Celestron.
Celestron 6900 or what?
I don't remember what it was.
Oh, okay.
Just said that.
I think my favorite outdoor activity, and will always be, although I can't really do it anymore. Well, I can, but is fishing and football. Fishing, I get to relax, and football,
fun.
I just get to wreck fools, but...
I remember when I was like 8 and I caught my first fish, I thought it was a boot, because I had caught a boot before that.
Really?
It was that comedy trope when you fish, I actually got a boot, I was like, what the hell is this?
I remember when I was a little kid.
I was
kid.
Like, I didn't think this was possible.
my grandparents are from Virginia, of course, and like they have a lake house back there.
Oh,
well,
yes. Sure.
I don't know. I don't remember. No, it wasn't their lake house. But I was with my grandpa, and I was fishing for bluegill, like right off the dock. Like, you could see him right there. And I accidentally dropped the hook through one of the wooden floorboards. And as soon as it hit the water, a bluegill took it. And so I had hooked a bluegill. But the line and the bluegill was between two wooden planks on the dock, so I couldn't pull it up. And I couldn't even get the hook out, so I had to, like, go get my grandpa, and he basically just... it was pretty bad. He ripped the face off the bluegill pretty much to get the hook out. Because it was... It absolutely swallowed the hook. It was nuts.
But... I'm going through my Facebook, because a lot of these things, that all my info, I had to change since I made it, which was freshman year, 8th grade. And so... It's all my political views, so it has the religious views, the political views. So it's like religious views, atheists, political views, don't even get me started. Which is still accurate to this day.
God. True. R.I.P. USA.
My about you is, you don't need to know anything about me.
Well.
I work at the Ministry of Magic. Ever since 2009.
Did you ever get that letter from Hogwarts?
I have an explanation for as to why I haven't.
Oh, really? Why is that?
Alright, so... Whenever... It was late 80s, early 90s when Voldemort was at his height and destroying all records of Muggles and mixed blood children, students that were all in line to get their letters when they were of age.
Mm-hmm.
I was in that range that was destroyed along with many other people.
Oh,
that's why I just never got my letter.
I see.
That's how these things work.
Makes sense.
Because I am obviously a wizard.
Yep.
Harry.
Nerd. Just kidding.
Everyone likes Harry Potter.
Yeah, me too. Oh, Donald Trump doesn't. No, it's Piers Morgan. He was bashing J.K. Rowling on Twitter. And he
oh,
said,
God. He said, J.K. Rowling on Twitter is the best thing.
Yeah. That was pretty funny.
She is freaking amazing.
Oh, gosh. All right. Let's see. Question number... What are we on? Five? No. Yeah, five. What chore do you absolutely hate doing? Not that you do chores, but...
I don't really actually do chores. No one tells me to do anything.
Yeah, true.
Because people are like, you don't do your... I could do my own laundry. I could do all this other stuff, but no one asked me to.
Wait, you don't do your own laundry? Are you serious?
Nope, because my mom's like, I'm going to do laundry. I could just do it. She's like, oh, I got fucking capped in the head by a teammate. Because I was like, I could just do it later. She's like, well, I'm going to put stuff in, so I'm going to just do it now. So just give me your clothes. Okay.
That's nice.
I'm not allowed to be self-sufficient, even though I can be.
How are you going to do that next year, Nathan?
Dude, I'm hyped as hell.
Are you?
Dude, I love being alone.
Oh, he's coming up the ladder. I can hear him. Great. Oh, that dude got wrecked! Are we lighting up that? Okay. So, you don't really do chores, therefore you can't really hate him.
I just do the trash, because, you know, trash. It's easy.
Yeah.
Well, I have to do it before anyone else does it, but I do it. Occasionally, if I walk past the dishwasher and there's just a bunch of dishes in there, I'm like, well, bothers me, so I'm going to do it.
Oh, because it bothers you, okay.
It's just all stacked and crazy. I'm like, I just feel like I have to fix this.
Yeah.
Because I feel like the fall and break gives me anxiety.
Jeez.
Other than that, that's pretty much it. Really don't do much.
Well,
chores do you do in your house, God, your home,
so
your
many.
Apartment?
So many.
Yeah?
I mean... Oh! I'm taking cover behind this shot. Grenade! Run! Freaking grits. Yeah. I think the ones I hate the most are the ones where I have to, like, get close to the ground. Like, cleaning the floor, or, like, the bathtub, I guess. Not necessarily the floor, because I don't really vacuum the floor. I don't Well, I do like clean it, but like when you have
our,
to, like...
our floors are hardwood, so I mean, so we wax and like clean them. But I need to do that in my room. That reminds me, I need to clean my floors.
I have a lot of stuff in my room.
Done that.
I need to move before I can clean, but I don't know.
To do all that crazy stuff to clean everything, but I was like, but if I actually do end up leaving this summer, then
My room back home from me moving out is still in chaos from me grabbing it. What was that? But it's still in chaos from me grabbing everything and leaving. I mean, when I go home for like weekends and breaks and stuff, like it's still pretty bad. Like I only use about, if I had to guess, like an eighth of my room, and the rest of it just has clothes and like old cabinets that are empty in it. They're just chilling.
Cabinets.
Oh my god, you would take freaking... Alright, guess I'll be Twitch.
Trash, dude. Only true. Austin Beast Twitch, and Twitch is trash.
Only Austin Beast Twitch?
Only Austin Beast Twitch.
Okay. Solid grammar.
I'm about the stem, not the English.
Yeah, I think my least favorite chore is cleaning the bathtub and the, toilet, just because I have to, like...
I just don't like that because of the smell of bleach and stuff.
Oh, I don't mind the smell of bleach, but...
It is strong.
That sounds bad.
I've ruined some of my good shirts.
I don't use bleach on any of my shirts. Well, I don't really wear anything white, so... Yeah.
I have a couple of shirts that are white.
I think... Yeah, well, the reason I don't really wear white clothes is the past few times I've gotten anything white, like, it just shrinks randomly. Like, I don't know why, it just does.
A t-shirt contest.
Oh. 10 out of 10 would
not. I hear something bad.
Oh, I thought I fell. Alright. Yeah, definitely the bathtub and the toilet, though. Alright, question number 6. Let's take a look-see. I don't think you have... Ah, got him! What's your favorite form of exercise, Nathan? It could be anything. What's your favorite physical activity, I guess?
Snowboarding, dude, obviously. It is so demanding. I just say that because I really don't do much other than that. Because, I mean, other than, like, just average, like going on a jog is just really boring.
True.
I don't.
Of course.
Like jog and stuff. Like I do them, but at the same time, it's kind of just mess.
I don't
nothing
jog.
To write home about.
Obviously.
A jog. I think it's a light J.
I jogged around the corner last week. It was a good jog. Alright, my favorite form of exercise probably, I mean, I've been going to the gym for the past few months, again, finally.
Shit. Biscuits.
And, I think my favorite thing to do has to be either leg press or bench press, because just leg press, I can do stupid amounts of weight.
Gains!
Hella gains. Well, not stupid amounts of weight. I bet JJ's gonna watch this and be like, fool! Get out of here, because, you know, JJ's dumb strong, but anyway, yeah. So, like, oh, did I tell you guys the story of the guys that were, like, watching me while I was leg pressing?
Yes.
It was really awkward. Oh, well, I'll tell you guys, you viewers. So, I was leg pressing, I had about, it was about probably... 700 pounds on, somewhere around there. It's like 8 plates, I think. I mean, subtract my body weight from that, and that's only about 400 pounds that I'm doing. But anyway, so I got done with my sets and my reps, and I start putting it away, and these two guys are watching me, and I was like, you know, like, you guys want it? And they're like, nah, we're good. And I was like, okay, so I keep putting it away. Mind you, this is 16 freaking plates. Well, not plates, but 16 45s. That was really, really annoying to put away. And so after I do it, I'm done. I'm dead tired. Or not tired, but just, you know, annoyed. And they jump on the leg press. I just kind of look back like, are you serious? I got to put all that away. All right, dude. You could have saved me from putting at least four of these away. But yeah, that was
my
story.
Make a video about it, Evan.
I should, dude. I should be like, so why did you decide to be a freaking ass?
Yeah, you and Austin just make videos about gains.
Hell yeah. Austin gets more gains than I do. I have a lot of gift wrap, shall we say, around my gains. So a lot of my gains just look like I'm eating more food. Which I've actually been pretty good with. I've been like meal planning and stuff, and I lost some weight, but nothing crazy. I lost my freshman 15. I'm actually kind of proud of that. I was like 330 at the end of last year, and I'm like at 313. Oh my god. But
I hate terror stuff.
So yeah. Dog. All right. So what's your favorite? That's a stupid question. All right, I'm gonna read this question word for word. Too busy looking at my phone, not looking at the stupid game.
Thought I could make a difference.
Shut up. This question says, what is your favorite time of day / day of the week / month of the year? For me...
Wait, I was not listening.
What is your favorite time of day / day of the week / month of the year? So feel free to answer that not at all or just one of those. I definitely hate
day
my
of
birthday.
The week.
But
day I of the think week. Birthdays are stupid. That is why I do not celebrate them.
Yeah, you're myself. A fool though, because if you celebrate it, then you get a lot of stuff. I haven't really celebrated my birthday
care
in the
if
past.
I get stuff.
You know, I don't think I've done.
Like, I don't want anything right
oh, left side, frick. I don't think I've done.
Like they
anything.
Always, they just want to have party. Yeah. I just had to make an agreement. I was like, you guys can donate to. my cousin.
The Nathan Fund.
Like, you could all donate to Todd's non-profit. And as long as I don't want a party.
That dude's dumb.
I'm a strange old hermit that lives past the Dune Sea.
I guess. No, I don't think I'm celebrating my birthday in. Gosh, I don't know when the last time it was I did anything for my birthday, to be honest. See, last birthday... My birthday is on Halloween, by the way, so it's like a lot of people have stuff to do, I guess. Because I'm, you know...
I know, it's like...
Second fiddle.
Why, but it's on like national holiday or something.
Yep. And then the day after that is Día de los Muertos, I think is what it's called. But
free money. Free candy. That you can later sell!
Not labeled for resale, but
I tried to do that when I was little.
Have you seen
actually,
those videos where it's like,
we...
it's like, be careful what's in your child's candy, and like they'll pull out like I don't know, just something random like,
yeah,
you know what I'm talking about.
No, God. My brother. And I... We mixed Gatorade and like Kool-Aid or something into a own drink, and we took the label off and stuff, and we like had a couple, and he would bring them to school with him, and then he'd also have gum and stuff, and he'd sell them to his friends, and his friends would like they'd actually buy them from him, and they'd spend money to get the gum or get the drinks.
Jeez.
It's like, I forgot how much money he made off of it. It was freaking the best.
There's this dude in...
Technically, I don't think it's illegal.
I don't know if Harrison's going to watch this, but me and Harrison had a PE class sophomore year. And there's this dude that sold candy. Yeah, when I transferred in, they made me take PE. But, and I was taking weight training at the same time. So I had 7 classes. 2 of them were physical education. That sucked. I like weight training, just regular PE sucked. But anyway, in my PE class, me and Harrison, there's this guy who sold candy. he like carried around a lunchbox every day, and you know, sometimes we bought candy from him, and he was like, I was like, yeah, can I get like, you know, like some Skittles? And he's like, oh sure. And I was like, oh, I only have a 20 though. And he looks at me, goes, psh, dude, I could break 100 if I needed to. And I was like, oh, okay, I don't think you needed to tell me that, but all right. But yeah, that dude's a fool. And all right, so I don't even remember what the question was.
I don't know either.
Number 8.
We just talked about days we don't like.
Yeah, true. How pessimistic.
Wait, was one of those favorite month or season?
Yeah,
or something?
Favorite day of the week. Oh, yeah, month of the year was one of them.
Month of the year. Let's see. So, although I would say December. I really like December.
Yeah, I like,
largely because
yeah.
That's now the month that a lot of December or May, but now largely because that's where all this when all the Star Wars movies are coming out. They used to come out in May, but yeah, I would say December. I mean, Christmas is awesome. The feeling of Christmas is beautiful. I may be an atheist, but I freaking love Christmas.
Yeah, well,
I don't even ask for stuff. I just like the feeling of it.
Well, you,
like, what do you want for Christmas? I was like, I don't want anything. I was like, I just like Christmas.
Yeah. Eliminate all hot. You have a big family too, so you get like.
I do have a big family.
Dumb amounts of stuff.
And my family is a family where I tell them, don't get me anything.
Yeah.
I don't want anything. I don't need anything. I just like to hang out because Christmas is really fun. But
yeah.
Of course, they insist to get me stuff. I mean, I'm not gonna. I feel bad if I tell them no.
Yeah.
Well, actually, that's a lie. I tell them no matter what. Still.
That was really risky.
Yeah, last time I jumped in this room, there were a bunch of nitro cells in here. Oh, we should go get that werewolf guy. Never mind, he's dead.
He gone. Bomber, left side. Oh, there's a guy that just passed by. Wrecked.
End of the hallway. He was shooting at you. I'm gonna throw a grenade.
Got him.
Oh, it's stuck to the wall!
Got him. Through the wall. He's not looking.
I was reloading. There's a bomber coming.
Yeah. There he is, right here. Can go down.
Let's go get L to Z. Some people's names are so hard to say, dude.
Yeah,
the
grizzly Ewok. Yeah, there were a lot of
nitro cells. My name is Greatest, and it is simple.
Gosh. All right.
Don't get Habana. Habana's gonna, or Lieutenant Zim. Lieutenant Zim. That's what it is. Maybe he's referencing Vader Zim.
All right. So number 8 is, what's your least favorite mode of transportation? That's a random question.
All of these are random.
I know they are.
But my least favorite mode of transportation.
Yeah.
Train.
Really? Trains are great.
Yep. Trains are boring.
No, they're not. You can get up and walk around.
I've been in a train for 5 hours.
Why?
And
I've been on a bullet train before. Yeah.
I went to Europe, and it was to go to King's Cross Station. And I was like, the most exciting part of that was I was going to King's Cross Station to platform 9 3/4. But other than that, I was like, okay. Trains are—they're all cool. I guess they're fine, but I don't know.
The London Underground.
Give me a
circuit.
Give me a.
Is hilarious.
Give me a. What's it called? Give me some context. What's the situation? Then we'll compare it. Where am I going? Where am I trying
raining,
to travel?
It's raining. You have groceries.
Groceries. Wait. This wouldn't apply.
You're living in New York City.
Oh well, then that's obviously gonna be. I would have to take the subway. I would not want to take a cab.
You could take a taxi.
I wouldn't hate to take a cab. I would not want to take a cab.
Yeah,
I'd never like taking cabs when I go to
New York. Just take an Uber, dude. Hello.
Ubers are weird.
Well,
cause
you'll have a car next year, but a lot of college students
try to talk to me. I hate it when cab drivers or whatever. I hate it when people try to talk to me. I was like, unless I initiate, like, because people feel awkward when there's nothing. Like, there's just that silence. I'm like, I'm a person that does not mind awkward silences. I could be totally comfortable, like, whatever. That other people
it's
have
not
to just
awkward. It's just
in,
the
saying,
silence.
Like, I'm uncomfortable.
Yeah.
I know. I'm just like, whatever. I'm fine with not saying anything. I'm just sitting here, mm-hmm. being on my phone. Being peaceful with my both earbuds in, trying to signal, hey, don't talk to me.
I guess. Or you're just exhibiting antisocial behavior.
Antisocial, I don't think that's accurate. I would say...
Are you a psychology major, Nathan?
I don't think so.
I know one. Let's get one on the phone right now. Hit up Kayla. Like, what's...
Bomb must be located and
right. I think my least favorite mode of transportation is... I guess it's all transportation that's too small. Like, I have not been in a car, plane, train, cab, or boat where I... Nah, I've been in...
Bicycle.
Well, you're right. I guess I haven't been in any major form of mass transportation where I have not been uncomfortable. I mean, like, when I went to Europe... When I went to just Virginia, when I went to like another time I took a plane, I don't remember.
Another plane, another train.
But anyway,
the brain.
I mean, like, I don't fit in those things. The armrests are too low because I'm. God. The seats. Like, they go halfway up my back, if that. So it's like I'm sitting in a school chair. And then my shoulders are super wide, so, like, I don't fit in a lot of places. But, yeah, just, I don't really like transport in general. If I could, I'd just...
Oh! Grenade. God damn it.
Give me another question. That question was weird. Yeah. This is a weird question. Wow, these are just getting more weird. What is your favorite...
Penis.
Yep, that could be an answer to the next question. What is your favorite body part? Oh my god. I don't even know how to answer that question. Because, like, there are reasons I would like certain body parts. Like, is it...
Wait, of myself?
Yes. Well, I don't know. See, it's not specific.
Okay, let's just assume it's of myself. Of myself, let's see. My eyes, because everything is plain, and I enjoy looking at my eyes.
Yeah, your eyes are pretty cool. Like, what? Like a
hazel? They're just, they're just a big variety of, like, variation of color.
Mm-hmm.
Because it can be a little gray, a little blue, a little green.
A little black. Get it?
Sometimes a little orange appears.
Really?
Yep. Occasionally.
Trippy.
It depends on how the sun hits it, though. That's all that matters.
Enemy has located. I think my favorite body part is probably... Honestly, my calves. Like, I don't even know why, but my calves are just...
Calves!
...really big and strong. Strong like ox! But, yeah. I don't even work on calves. I don't know why, but that's kind of like a pet peeve of mine. Like, when people are like, oh yeah, you know, here, we're at the gym, working my legs, trying to get some calves in, and it's like... Oh my god. Ah!
You got against people who like good looking calves, man.
I don't know, man. I guess my calves are just proportional to the rest of my leg.
Damn, my 47.
Bomb defused. Move to another bomb and defuse it.
God, freaking bomb.
Move to bomb location with the diffuser.
He's coming. Oh, wrecked.
Yeah. Oh.
That's so random, though.
Diffuser acquired.
Bomb
location.
Alright, next question. What's your favorite... This is weird. Kind of interesting, though. What's your favorite sound?
Oh. Well. I would say one of the... the sounds of the cosmos.
But there are... I'm not gonna fit.
I like the sound of a pulsar, if I'm gonna be entirely honest. It's very satisfying.
But I don't know, I know what my favorite sound is.
Generic sound, just that.
Well, it's kind of a joke. My favorite sound is the little beep the microwave does after it's done making your food.
I hate that noise. I'd always shut the microwave on before it happens, just because it pierces my ears.
Yeah.
I was saying, now I'm trying to go through my average day of just the sounds I hear.
I also hate the sound of, like, generic bedside alarm clocks. Like the... Yeah, that, like, gives me a heart attack and wakes
That's
me
why
up.
My alarm sound.
It does its job.
My alarm sound is Ray's theme from Force Awakens.
Mine is, like, just one of the generic, like, slow rise ones.
Nah, I've gotta be, it has to be abrupt.
I think... I don't really know what my favorite sound is, to be honest, like...
Wrecked!
Okay, I think I know what my favorite sound is. My favorite sound... is probably, yeah, it has to be one of my top few. It's just when someone, like on the football field, when a massive collision happens and someone just gets wrecked. I like the way that sounds.
I love the sound of brain damage.
Just crack, and just they hit the ground. That's pretty good. I like that sound.
I'll say mine is the sound of a rocket launch. Ugh.
I've never actually heard a rocket launch before. That'd be really cool.
You've never, like, if you just straight up, in person is my dream, but...
Yeah, that's what I mean. Because
I was watching the SpaceX launch live this morning, which is at, like, 6:30.
Yeah.
That's why I was up so early.
Yeah.
I had to turn it down a bit because Maddie was laying next to me because she was still asleep, but it was just the sense of... I was like, oh, so powerful, so awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, I also like, yeah, that's pretty cool. Like, I remember, it's kind of funny, almost a month ago at this point, I looked at videos just of, like, explosions, just to, like, see what they look like and their sound.
Explosions.
Yeah, and I don't know why, for some reason I clicked on some video, and, like, every explosion before it happened, someone would yell, I'm pretty sure, I don't want to assume that they were terrorists, but, you know. They'd yell some pretty crazy-ish before.
Oh, was it those memes? There was Allahu Akbar?
No, it was like legit unedited video where they'd yell that, and then the explosion would happen. I got kind of chills watching those videos. I was like, I don't want this, you know, to be on my internet history that I watched this, so I'm just going to exit out.
Yeah, I'm sure you're prime on the watch list there.
You never know, dude.
I've looked up plenty of things. I've looked up... let's go through just my recent searches that I've made. Is how to build a railgun. I'm going to build a railgun. This is confirmed. I will. Once I finish my physics series.
Yeah.
And everything, I'm gonna try to make my own one. But I'm gonna try to make it like a green one. Like, you know, good for environment and such. But you know, that's one of my goals.
Dude, you should like put a piece of metal inside a potato and then railgun that potato. That'd be sick. It's a potato gun, get it?
So many things with a railgun.
Oh, I know. But I mean, a railgun in terms of terrorism, which is...
Railguns do damage.
Yeah, but you can't...
They do damage.
You wouldn't be able to do anything.
It's not very portable. Exactly. That's what I'm gonna try to do though. I'm gonna try to make it portable. Not portable. I'm gonna try to make it portable.
What the hell?
Oh.
Come on.
Oh shit!
What?
No one covered that goddamn wall up.
Alright. Oh yeah.
I guess now I can cover it up.
Explosions are really cool. I think the biggest explosion I've ever witnessed is JJ had a. What was it? I don't even remember what it's called. It's like a M1000 or something like that. It's basically a quarter stick of dynamite. And he lit it off, and it like set off car alarms like two blocks away. It was intense. I have the video of that somewhere. Maybe I'll put that into the video for you guys to watch.
You have to put one link down. Just put the links to it in the bottom.
And then we also put it under.
Oh, dick!
Put it under a bucket. And the bucket went. It was nighttime, so the bucket went out of vision, out of view. It was really cool. Right. Let's get another question.
You got my death setup. Yeah, a little shimmy flight. Dude, but that moment when it was starting to lift off, it was so intense because like I hope they. Oh, sorry, dude. Don't move. God damn it! You moved.
Hostile insertion. Keep the hostage safe.
Who else needs help? Evan, need help?
Do
actually, I only
yeah,
have one more. Let's use this as an emergency.
Yeah, I'm chilling. I didn't put down my barbed wire.
Yeah.
Freaking great.
When that was first freaking lifting off though, my stomach was tensing up. I was like, oh, because I'm just remembering whenever there was a issue with the thrusters. I think it was last time.
On one of those explosions.
And then they had this scrub launch from yesterday.
Yeah.
That was because there was something wrong with
the booster
vectors
yeah,
software. It was the thrust vector software that was buggy, so they called off the launch.
On one of those explosion videos I looked up, I think it was one of the U.S. military soldiers. He captured some explosion online. It was like an airstrike, I think. And you see.
He didn't even try to run away from that.
What?
Shit.
And you see the explosion, and then you can see the shockwave coming towards him on camera. Like, it was crazy. Like, he goes, oh, there's the explosion. Like, a few seconds. Here comes a shockwave. And he goes, and he's, like, super loud. It was pretty cool. But, yeah. Anyway, explosions are cool. But I also like...
hostile insertion. Prepare to engage.
Collisions on the football field.
Want me to shoot him in the foot? I don't know what he's doing. I can't see.
Alright. I think this is going to be the last question. We're coming up on 50 minutes here. So, what do you want to be when you grow up, Nathan?
I'd like to be an engineer at NASA.
For
that's
sure.
The goal.
That kick, though.
Total ultimate dream. Of which would be pretty much anyone would be. Oh, I almost killed you, man. Oh, I did. Shoot.
I'm down. Help me.
Obviously.
Help me.
Yeah, I'm dead. We're all dead now.
Are we? Oh, the hostage is gone.
I
got wrecked.
Yeah, I knew I should have saved that last one for myself to revive myself. Oh, we lost.
What do I want to be when I grow up? I don't know what I want to be when I grow up, honestly. I think eventually I'd like to own a business and or a restaurant. But I know that's not very lucrative, so I don't know. At this point, I haven't found anything that interests me like that. I think. I mean, there's stuff that I'd like to do, but I don't know. I don't think that I'd be able to go through all the schooling for it. Like, I really like water, and I like nature, and like I said, I like fishing. So I, at one point, I always
thought
it'd be really cool. knock you out.
Dude, I like water.
I'm like 90%
water's
water.
The best. That's no. We're not that much of water.
I don't know, man.
We're not.
I'm pretty. It's not that fluid. But I'm
pumped. That was so bad. No.
Yeah, I know. But I don't know. When I was a kid, I thought it'd be cool to be like an oceanographer or an oceanologist. I don't know what the proper term for that is. It'd be really cool
an
to work.
Oceanographer?
Well, an oceanographer, you'd be like navigating or like mapping the ocean floor, wouldn't you? That's not what I meant. I guess a marine biologist. That's what I was looking for.
Marine biologist?
Yes.
Here are my goals for degrees. So engineering is going to be the first one, aerospace. Next one, physics, maybe astrophysics. Let's see. And then what was the other one I said? Oh, biology. Mm. I don't know where. Botany. Yeah, I want to specialize that. Be botanist, dude. Be Mark Watney. I'll make Martian potatoes one day, Evan. Just watch. I'm going to eat the shit out of them, too. Get it? Because he made the potatoes. Yep. Which shit is the fertilizer?
Yep.
Hilarious.
Hararious, man. Hararious.
I'm hararious. Well, let me put my thing down.
Alright, so I think that's about all the questions we have for today. Any closing remarks you'd like to throw in there?
Let's see. No.
Okay.
Oh, I don't know. Wait for Mass Effect Andromeda. I don't know.
True. Alright guys, well, if you're still here watching, thanks for watching. And like and subscribe. And we'll leave all the links for our social
medias
below.
Evan.
Yes.
Oh, Evan! You get shot.
Alright.
Wait,
and
look at me whenever you sign off.
This is Evan and Nathan
signing
off. And he just wrecked me. Alright, dude. For sure.
Son of a bitch.
Alright.